become jealousy of this time, you must watch. And then, if you don't do that, then you cannot get it.
That is that
So we are accumulating that karma, even if there is no body, physical action, and speech action. Still you are accumulating that karma. So if you accumulate that karma and that karma, then you can reach the hell. You can reach the view properly. That's what you have to do. So, even untamed elephant and crazy elephant, we also cannot have you that much. Compared to those effective emotions. So that is what we take here. Because the crazy elephant at most he can feel the head. And he cannot catch the hell, right? So that's what we take over there, you understand, and what we don't understand. And see that you reach that second chapter verse. Yeah. What is our
teeth?
Okay. How do you mean? Okay. Our teeth. Okay. In the same script, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now. That's the one. Now it's too much. I didn't just leave that out because the moon is better to give you the oral transcription. Love it too much. Now the third verse. To make the next half a year, can be long for some time, but that's the way you should go out and be a lot of it. Third word, that was all it is. Is it not? However, if the elephant of my mind is firmly down on all sides by the rope of mindfulness, all fears will cease to exist. And all verses will come into my hand. Okay, he says that all fears will be, what did he say? All fears will cease, all fears will cease, right? Yes, that is, fear of obstacles, fear of getting to hell, fear of having from the others, fear of meeting, all kinds of fear to get the beating, all these kinds of things. You know? So this is considered fear. All the unwanted things. They are considered fear. They are referring to fear. Fear means all unwanted things. They are all these things. They are all these things. Because if you control, in Buddhism, everything is, in Buddhist philosophy, everything there is. Some internal experiences according to different schools, but in general, everything is created by your mind. The whole world is created by your mind. The whole universe is created by your mind. If you control your mind, you can control the whole world. The whole universe. Okay? So, since we don't remind Sato our mind, then the world is not in our control, and the universe is not in our control. So they control us, right? So if you control your mind, okay? That means, at the beginning, that we train our country, our mind, that we train our way of thinking, how to think, to change. And for that, I think the mind training is very good, how to train, to control our anger, and how to develop the loving kindness, how to develop feeling of compassion, feeling of compassion towards others. We are so when we then put our thoughts into the constructive emotion. Controlling our mind. So slowly we can control everything, you know? Like a highly realized Mahasiddhi, Mahasiddhi. There's nothing that they can do, there's nothing that they can work control. Because they have control them totally. So the highly realized Mahasiddhi, they say, for example, this is a small thing, but also what they can do is that they have to point their finger and then drop the food from the feet. And then they can point their finger to the fruit and then attack to the tree. The earth of the tree was never flat. And it took back to the tree and began to have it never fell down. So that kind of control. So it is easy to imagine. And we get that it's not a special thing, but there is that. So he says that all kinds of things that appear in the sea, right? The things that go out there. So it's very important to train and go out there. Put our thoughts in concentric heart. The word concentric heart. Please read it out for us. We'll see. Guidance of the hell world, evil spirits, and turn it off. But it's hanging off. Oh, okay, turn it off. Turn it off. Simple, turn it off. So, you understand? Tigers, lions, animals, bears, snakes, and all kinds of enemies, and the guardians of the heaven, even snakes. Okay, then you... Oh.
So, even if you know the meaning of emptiness,
they basically, at the moment, you need to have a general definition. And you can't see it correctly. And when you see it correctly, that means you see the emptiness as if you see the glass and the table and our eyes. That is how you see it correctly. So that means that the first ground, So after seeing emptiness correctly, when you see emptiness correctly during the meditation, you cannot see emptiness correctly when you rise out of meditation. When you are in meditation, then you are totally involved in that object, whatever object you do. This time we are talking about emptiness. The emptiness is the object. So during the meditation, the uninterrupted meditation, what we call it. At that time, for example, uninterrupted meditation on emptiness, we see emptiness directly. And that is the light there. Actually, it is inexpressible, you are into that. So, almost you become inseparable. So during that time practice, and you cannot stay like that forever. You have to get out of it. That is after meditation, at least. So after meditation, you will see everything as normal. But since you have seen emptiness directly, you see things, but it is like music. You can see like you see things, everything like things on the screen. So the disciple who has reached to the first ground level, they advise you to study to the beggar, to work the part of their body, that they touch their body, they don't feel the pain. They don't feel the pain. So what about that question? Yes. Ultimate reality, emptiness is the same. There could be one example, you know, that when you control things there, something there, so forth, and you don't keep things. So similarly, if you control your mind and then slowly you can change anything according to this. It's not a big deal, you know. So at the moment we are not in this situation. The perfect teacher himself has shown that in this way all fears, as well as all boundless misery, originate from the mind. This is without the word. Yes? The teacher of reality. Here is the perfect teacher. So anyway, that is Buddha, referring to Buddha. So all the tears and all the suffering, arise from mind. And they were stated by Buddha himself in his sutra. So that is what he says. And in this one sutra, Buddha sutra, and then in that there are cloud of Buddha. In that sutra he says that if you overpower your mind, overpower your thoughts, then all phenomena will be controlled. Same in this sutra. And he said the virtuous action or the non-virtuous action, they all are accumulated by your thoughts, our mind. And since you come to the world, the thought is what do you say? That has to go prior to all phenomena. These are the Buddha's words in the sutra. The thought, the mind, that has to go prior to all phenomena. So that means all come from there, from the mind. Right? Okay? Understand? Okay. So, you have read? The seven is Santideva Sutra not to be given in seven. That is such a thing, he may not have achieved it. And that there are some things that they think for us to be able to. Who intentionally created all the weapons for those in hell? Who created the burning iron ground that is in the hell? From where did all the women ensue? All the women in the hell. So how come all the, who made or who created all the, and you know? Yeah, please read out. So anyway, you know that when the hell really is explained in sutra, so what you think, that there are two kinds of heaven. One is the hot heaven, the cold heaven, and the hot heaven, all the grounds are iron ground, and they're heated, and they're red iron ground, and the iron heated, and fully heated, the iron becomes red, right? So the red iron heated ground, and you have to walk on that with bare foot, and then you are hit by different kinds of weapons, and then there is one explained that there is one, what do you call that, tree, the leaves are sharp, kind of like. So when you are at the root of the tree, then your girlfriend is up in the up on the top of the tree, and then your girlfriend is calling you, come here, come here, come here, darling, I'm here. Come here, sweetheart, I'm here. So you hear that word, and then you are so happy, and you climb up to the tree, top of the tree, and all the leaves, they turn downwards, the sharp leaves, like a knife. So when you climb up, your body is cut everywhere, you got cut. And then when you reach there, your girlfriend isn't there, your girlfriend is at the bottom top of the tree, and then again she's calling you, oh, I'm here, you know. So then, your girlfriend or boyfriend, it doesn't matter, you know, it's an example. And then again, you are climbing down, right? And then all the they turn upwards, and then you climb downwards, again you got cut all your parts of the body. So that is all endless, like that. And you never get tired, that is because of your karma. You, when you hear again, then you go again upwards. that is endless. So that is, maybe it is an example that Buddha has given to us so that we can imagine something. So otherwise, it is not necessary there is a tree always there, because, you know, and there is an iron ground always there. That is not physically, whether it is there or not, this is a question. We don't find, scientists, they don't, so far they couldn't find any kind of the hell world, you know. So physically, whether it is there or not,